Now, moving on to the next thing is allocation of impairment loss. Allocation of impairment loss in case of CGU. Now, for example, say we have a CGU, okay? We have a CGU on which loss is incurred. Ki CGU ka samjho carrying value rahega, say 100, and recoverable value is say only 80. Now, in this case, there is an impairment loss of 20. The question is, how will we allocate this loss to CGU? As CGU will have a, CGU is a group of assets, jahan pe A, B, C, D, bahut sare machine rahenge. So, how will we allocate this impairment loss in case of CGU is what we will be dealing with it right now. So, samjho, there is a CGU in which there are four assets A, B, C, D. Carrying value is 10, 20, 30 and 40. Say carrying value, so total CGU ka carrying value kitna ho gaya? Total carrying value of CGU is 100. Say recoverable value of the entire CGU is 150. Here you will say, since the CGU carrying value is less than the recoverable value, hence CGU is not impaired. Hence CGU is not impaired. Here, ek hi problem hai. Now, even if the individual assets are impaired, it's not possible to find out. Apan bolenge, there's no impairment loss only. Hence, because the carrying value of CGU is less than the recoverable value, hence none of the assets are impaired. We'll say CGU hi impaired nahi hai. But what if the recoverable value here is 90? Now, what are we going to do? There is an impairment loss. The CGU is only impaired. Impairment loss of rupees 10. What will we write? Apan to likh denge. Impairment loss account debit 10 to CGU 10. Now tell me, in balance sheet mein, is there anything which is appearing in the name of CGU? Balance sheet mein toh aapke machine dekhenge, machine A, B, C, D, 10, 20, 30, 40. In balance sheet mein, there is nothing known as CGU. So, how will we allocate an impairment loss to something which is not there in the balance sheet? So, this impairment loss is to be allocated. This impairment loss is to be allocated in some ratio to the respective machine. Because aapko 10 rupay ka impairment loss batana hai, but there is nothing known as CGU karke. In the balance sheet, you will have A, B, C, D. So, this 10 rupees impairment loss will have to be allocated between all these machines in some ratio. So, the best ratio what we can think of is, ki, sir, A, B, C, D, there are four machines. Carrying value is 10, 20, 30, 40. Now, impairment loss is 10. So, why not do this in the ratio of carrying value only? Why don't we divide this entire loss in the carrying value? That is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, carrying value minus impairment will give you your return on value of the machine. Now, the problem is, what if A and B are not impaired only? Just because CGU impaired ho raha hai, or just because dusre machine impaired ho raha hai, you are impairing, aap impairment loss A or B ko bhi jaro, but what if A and B are not impaired only? So, standard says, in case you can prove, standard says, if you can prove that A and B are not impaired, then we won't allocate any, impairment loss. We won't allocate any impairment loss to A and B. Are we clear? So standard say, you prove it. If you can prove, then don't allocate. Nahi to sabko impairment loss ka thoda thoda proportion aane hi wala hai. So what we do is, we try to find here, net selling price and value in use for each and every machine. Ki har machine ke liye dhoondte, if it's to the extent possible, ki we have to prove if A and B are not impaired, apne kuch na kuch to kaise prove karna padega. So say, for simplicity, we cannot find value in use because none of the machine generate independent cash flow, so value in use to nikalna possible hi nahi hai. But we can sell ABCD machine. If ka apan selling price or net selling price to nikali sakte, correct? say the net selling price for all the four assets is, so for each asset is 20, ठीक है, तो पूरे CGU का net selling price कितना हो गया, 80 rupees. Here, now see, machine A, machine B, machine C and machine D, ठीक है, carrying value is 10, 20, 30, 40. Now, net selling price, you calculated 20, 20, 20 and 20. Value in use, आपको individual का नहीं पता, that's why we have gone to CGU level and CGU level का value in use is 90. The carrying value of the entire CGU is 100, जो अपन ने देखा. Hence, we take whichever is higher and अपन बोलते हैं 10 rupees का impairment loss है. Now the challenge comes. तो आपने अभी तक क्या किया, 1, 2, this is the loss which you have given. Now what does machine, now if you look at the table, आपको मालूम पड़ेगा machine A के लिए you are saying that carrying value is 10, you have given, जबरदस्ती आपने 1 rupees impairment loss दे दिया है, carrying value becomes 9. But A can say, boss, you see, I can easily give you a net selling price of 20. आप कैसे बोल सकते हो मैं इंपेयर हुआ, आई एम एबल टू फेच यू स्टिल अ वैल्यू ऑफ 20 इफ यू गो इन द मार्केट एंड हाउ कैन यू इंपेयर, हाउ कैन यू गिव मी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस. सेम इज फॉर बी, बी इज लाइक आई हैव लाइक माई कैरिंग वैल्यू बिकम्स 18, अगर आप मुझे एलोकेट करोगे इंपेयरमेंट लॉस, मेरा कैरिंग वैल्यू 18 हो जाएगा बट स्टिल आई एम एबल टू फेच 20, सो हाउ एम आई एबल, लाइक हाउ आर यू गिविंग मी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस. बट इन केस ऑफ सी एंड डी, इफ यू सी, this is 27 and this is 36. Now here you can say ki still ye 27 hai carrying value, net selling price is 20, matlab there is a possibility that C and D have impaired. Again we cannot, so but we are able to prove ki A and B to impaired nahi hue, C and D we cannot prove, but so we'll have to give the impairment loss to C and D. So in such case here for A and B we can prove that it is not impaired. For A and B, we can easily prove it is not impaired because the machines are capable of giving a value more than the carrying amount. Matlab, agar aapne usko impairment kiya, if you have already impaired it, but still the asset is able to fetch you more than the carrying value. So you can say ki A and B have never been impaired. So hence, जो भी impairment loss होगा 10 rupees का, that will be divided between C and D because there is no other way you can prove that C and D have not been impaired. So in the question, if net selling price is not given, so in this case we had net selling price of 20, 20, तो अपन ने prove कर दिया, but if this is not given only, then you cannot prove that A and B are not impaired. Then you have to allocate the entire impairment loss of 10 in the ratio of their carrying value. So how to prove, if you have individual recoverable value, that is NSP or value in use to the extent available, if that is possible, then only. So if the recoverable value, that is 20, is greater than the carrying value, so aap bol sakte ho impairment nahi hua hai, but if the recoverable value is less, that is in case of machine C, recovered value, that is NSP, is less than the carrying value, then you cannot prove that the machines have not been impaired. You will have to allocate the loss of impairment between machine C and D. Are we clear? Great. Now, let's go to the next part, that is allocable goodwill. Now, many years back, Parle, which is a brand, they owned, they had two more brands under them, that is known as Gold Spot. This is basically, it was an aerated drink which was orange in color, jo aajkal Fanta dekhte ho, waisa pehle Gold Spot tha. And they had Thumbs Up. Okay. Now what happened? Coke came and acquired both the brands by paying, of course, abhi itne bade brand diya hoga, toh goodwill bhi hoga. He must have paid for all the machines of Gold Spot, all the machine of Thumbs Up, and he must have also paid, say, goodwill. He must have also paid for goodwill. Goodwill of 100 rupees. So now when Coke acquired Gold Spot, Coke ko kuch marketing strategy change karna tha. He was like, Gold Spot nahi chal raha itna market mein. I'll have to relaunch it, yeah, rebrand it or make it something else. Thumbs Up is still working, not an issue. But with Gold Spot, I'm not happy. I'll have to discontinue this product. The moment you say you discontinue this product, matlab aap bol rahe ho, Gold Spot is impaired. Matlab abhi Gold Spot brand ke piche jo iska CG hoga, see, for Gold Spot, you'll have machine A, machine B, machine C. Char machine honge, jisme ek mein liquid banta hoga. One must be adding sugar, one must be making the bottle, one must be sealing the bottle. Pura ek bottling unit hoga ye. Correct? Now, the moment you say that Gold Spot is impaired, to ye all the machine, this entire CGU is becomes impaired. So, abhi if you see, it's not just the entire machine. Khali ABCD impaired nahi hua hai. बट आपने जो गुडविल लाया था गोल्ड स्पॉट के लिए whatever goodwill you got, even that is impaired. So here, what will we consider that goodwill is a part of CGU. We will allocate जितना भी goodwill आपने 100 रुपीज का आपने goodwill लाया था. If you paid 100 rupees for the goodwill, 50 is for Gold Spot, 50 is for Thumbs Up. Hence, we will consider CGU including goodwill. It is not just machine A, B, C, D, but also allocable goodwill of 50 rupees, which is a part of CGU. So hence, if ABCD, kal uth ki agar ABCD impaired ho raha hai, if the machines ABCD are getting impaired, then somewhere the goodwill is also getting impaired. It's an asset jiska value aapko aage aane nahi wala hai, even this is getting impaired. Are we clear? So now, one second. So now, what are the assets in your CGU? If I ask you Gold Spot CGU, what are the assets you have? You have machine A, you have machine B, C, D and goodwill. That is 10, 20, 30, 40, goodwill of 50 rupees. So the carrying value of the CGU becomes 150. Now, goodwill is an asset. Now, you don't have a separate net selling price for goodwill because goodwill aap bech nahi sakte. If you want to sell goodwill, you'll have to sell business. So it won't have a net selling price, nor it will have a value in use because goodwill alone won't generate revenue. It will help you to contribute more revenue. Agar goodwill hoga, to aapko market mein achha price kamana hoga aapke product ka. So goodwill will help in generating more revenue, but itself alone, uska koi cash revenue, it cannot generate independent cash flow. So now, suppose your say recoverable value of the entire goodwill is 90. So what is the impairment loss? Impairment loss comes to 60. Now this 60, how will we allocate this 60? Kidhar karenge? A, B, C, D, goodwill, everyone in the ratio or what? So the standard says that goodwill cannot have value in use. That is, it will not contribute towards the future cash flow. So if goodwill hoga, to price milega, nahi to nahi milega. So sabse pehle, if the asset is impaired, if you bought Gold Spot and Gold Spot impaired, okay, sabse pehle, see, what is goodwill? Goodwill is as a result of super profit. Super profit hoga, isliye goodwill hai. But now, if there is impairment, aap normal profit bhi earn nahi kar sakte. Goodwill is something, because of super profit, goodwill hota hai. But because now there is impairment, you are not in the state to earn normal profits also. So the fact that the assets are impaired, matlab goodwill sabse pehle impaired hoga. So now 60 rupees of impairment loss first will have to be allocated, will first have to be allocated to goodwill, and then it will go to all the other asset. It will go to all the other asset in ratio of their carrying value, unless you prove that in some cases there is no impairment. Otherwise, the entire impairment loss after going to goodwill will go to the other asset in the ratio of carrying value. Are we clear? Now, there is one more concept which is known as corporate asset. Corporate asset matlab kya? Suppose Nestle company, which is of FMCG company, it has many products. It makes Maggi, it makes biscuits, then it makes even soap, toiletries. Now Nestle has an R&D department. इनके पास एक research department है R&D, जो Maggi के लिए भी research करेगा, जो biscuits अलग अलग flavors के लिए भी research करेगा, and they will even research for different soap, what soap में क्या होगा, soap में what they can introduce and everything. Now what is corporate asset? Now this R&D department is nothing but a corporate asset. This R&D department is nothing than but a corporate asset which will contribute to the cash flow. देखो R&D के बिना चल नहीं सकता, but R&D department itself cannot generate cash flows. R&D if you see it cannot itself generate cash flows. Under review. So what होगा क्या कि कल उठ के understand. कल उठ के इफ गवर्नमेंट बैंस मैगी मतलब देयर इज एन इंडिकेटर ऑफ इंपेयरमेंट. सो इट इज वेरी मच ऑब्वियस दैट द आरएनडी डिपार्टमेंट जो मैगी का दिखता था इवन दैट इज गेटिंग इंपेयर्ड. बट नाउ हाउ विल यू इंपेयर आरएनडी डिपार्टमेंट? आप आरएनडी डिपार्टमेंट को इंपेयर कैसे करोगे? व्हाट विल यू डू इज कि जितना भी एलोकेबल आरएनडी पार्ट है मैगी को आप उसके सीजीयू में लेके जाओ. So now your CGU will have A, B, C, D तो हो गई. You will have goodwill also and you will have a corporate asset also which is allocable to R&D, which is allocable to Maggi department. So corporate asset directly you cannot impair. The only way to impair R&D is you take it to their part of the CGU. So if R&D department said 20% is applicable to Maggi department, so 20% R&D का you will allocate it to the CGU unit of Maggi. And then you will check the entire CGU's impairment. This is known as corporate asset. So, just going through the entire thing. So, if you ask me what is corporate asset and what are the characteristics, so what I will say is that corporate asset, kaise hai, they do not generate cash flow. Ye individually kabhi cash flow generate nahi kar payega, independently of each other. And their carrying value also cannot be fully attributed. Now, entire R&D department say 100 rupees, I cannot fully attribute to one CGU. Ye alag alag CGU mein jaake baitega and then you will check for impairment. So, in case if government bans Maggi, to Maggi to ban hoga, Maggi ke assets to ban honge, impairment honge, but whatever R&D jo attributable hai Maggi department ko, even that will be impaired. Are we clear? Now, this are known as corporate assets. So the only way to test corporate asset, देखो ये भी एक asset है जिसको impairment के लिए test करना पड़ेगा, but the only way to test this corporate asset is in the context of the CGU in which it is used for. So now, what are the steps? Now let's write down the steps to allocate impairment loss in case of CGU. So first thing, आपको अगर impairment loss CGU का निकलना, first thing you have to calculate the carrying value of CGU. What is the carrying value of CGU? All your assets, जितने भी carrying individual assets है, carrying value of all individual assets, that is machine A, B, C, D. Then if there is any allocable goodwill, अगर आपने pay किया है goodwill के लिए, there is any allocable goodwill, you will add the goodwill also. And if there is any corporate asset, allocable corporate asset, these three things jaake aap jab add karoge tab jaake what you get is carrying value of entire CGU. Now this will be tested for impairment. Are we clear? After this, what was the next step? एक बार आपने ये calculate कर दिया, then you will calculate recoverable value. For the entire CGU, एंटायर सीजीओ का आपको रिकवर वैल्यू देखना पड़ेगा। रिकवर वैल्यू मतलब क्या हो गया, हायर ऑफ नेट सेलिंग प्राइस और वैल्यू इन यूज। एंटायर सीजीओ का वैल्यू इन यूज यू विल हैव एंड नेट सेलिंग प्राइस यू विल हैव, तो उन दोनों का जो भी हायर होगा दैट विल बी कंपेयर्ड विद द कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ द सीजीयू। आर वी क्लियर? आफ्टर दैट द थर्ड स्टेप इज नथिंग बट इंपेयरमेंट लॉस। इफ द कैरिंग वैल्यू इज मोर, इफ द कैरिंग वैल्यू इज मोर देन द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू देन इंपेयरमेंट लॉस होगा, दैट इज 1-2। आर वी क्लियर? चलो ग्रेट। नाउ इन केस देर इज एन इंपेयरमेंट लॉस विच वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, अगर इंपेयरमेंट लॉस हुआ तो द फर्स्ट थिंग इट हैज टू बी रिटन ऑफ, इट हैज टू बी रिटन ऑफ अगेंस्ट एलोकेबल गुडविल। यू हैव टू राइट इट ऑफ अगेंस्ट एलोकेबल गुडविल। आफ्टर दैट इफ उसके बाद भी देर इज एनी एक्सेस लॉस, आफ्टर दैट ऑल्सो इफ देर इज एनी एक्सेस लॉस इट शुड बी रिटन ऑफ, इट शुड बी रिटन ऑफ अगेंस्ट ऑल अदर इंडिविजुअल एसेट्स, अगेंस्ट ऑल इंडिविजुअल एसेट्स इंक्लूडिंग कॉर्पोरेट असेट। उसको भी आपको इंपेयर करना पड़ेगा इन द रेशियो ऑफ कैरिंग वैल्यू। बट इफ यू कैन प्रूव दैट सम असेट इज नॉट इंपेयर्ड, वो आप कैसे प्रूव करोगे कि आफ्टर एलोकेटिंग द कॉर्पोरेट लॉस, आफ्टर एलोकेशन ऑफ इंपेयरमेंट लॉस, वन सेकंड, देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद द सिस्टम। सो आफ्टर द एलोकेशन ऑफ इंपेयरमेंट लॉस इफ द कैरिंग वैल्यू इज गोइंग बियॉन्ड नेट सेलिंग प्राइस, अगर आपने जो अपने एग्जाम्पल में देखा, इफ द कैरिंग वैल्यू You had 10 rupees, आपने उसको 1 rupees का impairment loss दिया, carrying value came to 9, and if it is going below the net selling price, that means that asset is not impaired, तो उसको आप कभी भी impairment loss नहीं दोंगे। So to write it, if the allocation of impairment loss should ensure that carrying value of individual or corporate asset should not fall below the individual net selling price। जैसे अपने को एग्जाम्पल में याद आएगा, जब ए बी सी डी था, द मोमेंट 10, 20, 30, 40 था, आप यू वॉन्टेड टू गिव 1 rupees इंपेयरमेंट लॉस टू दिस, टू टू दिस, थ्री टू फोर टू दिस, तो कैरिंग वैल्यू कितना आया था, 9, 18, 27 and 36। But your net selling price was how much? 20, 20, 20, 20. So your allocation of impairment loss should ensure, जब आप allocate कर रहे हो, it should ensure that the carrying value जो आ रहा है, this should not fall below net selling price. The moment this falls below the net selling price, मतलब वो asset impaired है ही नहीं. Are we clear? So let's take an example, so it will be more clear. So say a CGU has 3 identifiable asset, that is X, Y, Z. It has an allocable corporate asset also, that is asset A, and it has goodwill also. Okay, this is a full-fledged thing where a machine has like a CG unit has everything. So carrying value kitna hai? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, total CGU comes to 150, total carrying value. Net selling price you have for each 20, 20, 20. Corporate asset can be also be sold, it won't have value in use, but it will have a net selling price. In case of goodwill, there will be no net selling price. So how much is the net selling price total of CGU? 80. Value in use won't be there for any of the assets you will have a total value in use for the CGU. So in this case, the step one apna kya tha, we have always have to calculate first the carrying value, which we have already done, that is 150. This is your step one jo apne abhi just upar likha hai. Second, calculate recoverable value. What is recoverable value? Whichever is higher, that is 90. So this is your step two. Step three is calculate impairment loss. That is how much? 150 minus 90, that is 60 rupees of impairment loss. This is your step three. And now step four. What is the step four? That you have to allocate the impairment loss in some particular pattern. The first thing it will go to. Now first thing, impairment loss of rupees 60, the first it will be allocated to goodwill, which is of 50, and rest will be allocated to other assets in ratio of, in proportion of carrying value. However, if you see, if you give any impairment loss to this two particular X and Y, or you can say, if you give any particular impairment loss to X, Y, so their carrying value will always fall below the net selling price. So, unko kabhi impairment lagega hi nahi. But here, since we have been given net selling price, we are able to prove that X and Y are not impaired. Hence, the whole loss of 10 will be borne by Z and corporate asset A. So in the ratio of the carrying value, that is 30 is to 70 into 10 and 40 is to 70 is to 10. That is 4.29 and this is nothing but 5.71. Are we clear? So now what will the journal entry? It will be impairment loss account debit 60. To goodwill, that is 50, to C, that is 4.29, and to D, 5.71. So this is how we will allocate if any impairment loss to a CGU in the ratio of, first it will go to goodwill, then rest it will go to all the other assets including corporate asset, unless you can prove that a particular machine is not impaired. So now let's go to illustration number 10. XYZ Limited has a CGU, that is a cash generating unit plant A, on 1st April 2011 of value of 1000 CR as on 1st April 2011. Plant A was acquired under a business combination and goodwill of rupees 200 crore was allocated to it. So you had allocable goodwill also of 200 CR. It is depreciated on a straight line basis. Plant A has a useful life of 10 years with no residual value. On 31st March 2012, plant A has a recoverable amount of 600 crores. Calculate the impairment loss on plant A. Also prescribe its allocation as per Ind AS 36. So what will we do? First, we'll calculate the carrying value. Samajhne ke baad hai. So when are we doing the impairment testing? That is on 31st March 2012. So carrying value first as on 1411 kitna hai? 1000 CR. Then we will depreciate it. Depreciation how much? That is 1000, 10 years ka life hai into 1 year. That is, we will depreciate it by 100 rupees. Correct? After that, what will be the carrying value of the asset? That is, WDV or carrying value of the asset becomes how much? 900. Now, we are doing a CGU level impairment. So, now we will also add. The first step is to calculate the carrying value of the entire CGU. We'll also add allocable goodwill of how much? 200. So what is the carrying value of the CGU? Carrying value of the entire CGU is nothing but 1100. Correct? Now, Recoverable value as on 31st March 12 is given as 600. Hence, in this case, impairment comes to 500 rupees. Correct? Now, the next step is the allocation of impairment loss. So, 500 loss जो आपने incur किया है, the loss of 500, impairment loss of 500, out of which, first it will be written off against the goodwill of rupees 200, and rest it will be written off against the plant which is available, that is other asset. Always remember, goodwill does not get amortized. Goodwill, we always check for annual impairment. It has indefinite life, it always tested. So goodwill, even if you bought it 1 year back, the value will still remain same, and we'll all annually check it for impairment. Are we clear? Let's go to illustration number 11. Earth Infra Limited has two cash generating units, that is X and Y. They have two CGUs, they have clearly mentioned. There is no goodwill within the unit's carrying value. The carrying value of CGU A is 20 million and carrying value of CGU Y is 30 million. The company has an office building which is using as an office headquarter and has not been included in the above value and can be allocated to the units on the basis of their carrying value. They have clearly mentioned that there's something called a corporate asset which has not been included in this value, which we will have to do after this. The recoverable amounts are based on the value in use of 18 million for CGU X and rupees 38 million for CGU Y. Determine whether the carrying values of CGU X and Y are impaired or no. So again, we'll have to check it for individual. The first step is to determine the carrying value of the entire CGU. So carrying value of the entire CGU, individual assets do you have? Carrying value of entire CGU. It is forming when you have individual asset and you have something which is known as corporate asset, which you allocate nahi kiya hai. So how much is the value of the corporate asset? That is 10. In what ratio? In the ratio of carrying value you will do. So into 20 upon 50, and here it will be 10 into 30 upon 50. That is rupees 4 and that is rupees 6. So what is the total carrying value you got? Total carrying value aapka kitna hai? 24 and 36. Now, what is the recoverable value? Recoverable value they have clearly given, that is 18 million, that is 18 million for CGU X and 38 million for CGU Y. So how much is the impairment in case of CGU X? Carrying value is 24, that is greater than recoverable value, hence impairment loss will be carrying value minus recoverable value, that will be 24 minus 18, that will be 6. In the other case, that is CGU Y, there is no impairment loss because carrying value is less than the recoverable value, hence there is nil impairment. So now we have to allocate the impairment loss. We have to allocate the impairment loss first. In here, we don't have any goodwill or anything. Aisa kuch hai nahi. So the entire loss will be allocated to the individual asset and corporate asset in the ratio of their carrying value. So that is 6 rupees into 20 upon 24. That will be allocable to individual asset, and to corporate asset, we will allocate 6 into 4 upon 24, that is 5 and 1. Are we clear? Great. So now, what to do in case there is reversal of impairment? If there is reversal of impairment in case of a CGU, till now, apne pura jo bhi dekha ki reversal of impairment happened when a machine is impaired. But what if there is a reversal of impairment of CGU? द सेम थिंग जो आपने उधर किया था, सेम चीज इधर आपको फॉलो करना है. द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ रिवर्सल फॉर अ सीजीयू विल बी सेम एज ऑफ इंडिविजुअल असेट. जो आपने इंडिविजुअल असेट के अपने स्टेप्स देखे थे, इट्स द सेम प्रिंसिपल, कुछ नया नहीं है इसमें. सो अगेन रिवर्सल कैन ओनली हैपन, बेसिक प्रिंसिपल क्या है, रिवर्सल कैन ओनली हैपन इफ देयर इज एन इंक्रीज इन सर्विस पोटेंशियल. देन एक बार अगर गुडविल इज इंपेयर्ड, यू कैन नॉट डू अ रिवर्सल ऑफ गुडविल, बिकॉज गुडविल इज समथिंग, अगर आपने वापस उसको रिवर्स करने गए, इट विल लीड टू अ सेल्फ जनरेटेड गुडविल विच इज नॉट अलाउड. एंड रिवर्सल शुड इंश्योर दैट आपका जो भी रिवर्सल है कि कैरिंग वॉट एवर इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू, दैट शुड नॉट बी और दैट शुड बी लोअर ऑफ recoverable value and carrying value ignoring impairment. This we already discussed, same hai ki aapka jo bhi carrying value hai after reversal, that should be lower of recoverable value and carrying value. Rest all principles are same, there is nothing new in this. So let's look at the illustration. Illustration number 12. On 1st April 2011, Venus Limited acquired 100% of Saturn for rupees 4 lakh. The fair value of the net identifiable asset of Saturn Limited was 3 lakh 20, and goodwill was rupees 80,000. Saturn Limited is in a coal mining business. On 31st March 2013, that is after 2 years, the government had cancelled the license given to it in few states. As a result, Saturn Limited revenues estimated to get reduced by 30%. Now, the adverse change in the marketplace and regulatory condition is an indicator of impairment. As a result, Venus Limited has to estimate the recoverable amount of goodwill and net asset on Saturn Limited on 31st March 2013. That is, you bought a new business only on 1st April 2011, 2 years later, some regulatory changes happened and that indicated impairment. Venus Limited used to use a straight line depreciation. The useful life of Saturn Limited asset is estimated to be 20 years with no residual value. No independent cash flows can be identified to any individual asset. So the entire operation of Saturn is stated to be a CGU. Pura operation ko hi CGU maan liya hai. TK, not an issue. Due to regulatory entangle, it is not possible to determine the net selling price, the selling price of Saturn Limited as a CGU. Its value in use is estimated by the management at 2,12,000. Now, suppose by 31st March, the government reinstates the license of Saturn. Again, after 2 years, government reinstates the license. The management accepts a favorable change in the net cash flow. This is an indicator that impairment loss may have to be reversed. The recoverable amount of Saturn's limited net asset is re-estimated. The value in use is expected to be 3,04,000 and the fair value less cost to disposal is expected to be 2,90,000. So this is a typical case where there is impairment of CGU and there is reversal of CGU. So let's start. The solution is given on page number 5.7 of solution book. So Saturn Limited, now you have goodwill and other asset. So let's do it separately only. So on 1-4-2011, cost, goodwill, how much did you acquire the goodwill for? 80,000. And rest other asset, you have acquired for 3,20,000, correct? So total CGU ka value, your total value is 4 lakh. Now 2 years have passed and there are indicators of impairment. To pehle less depreciation. Goodwill will never depreciate or amortize. It is always be taken for annual impairment checking. We never amortize the goodwill. But other asset which is a PP, it gets depreciated over the period of time. So 3,20,000, they have clearly mentioned that the life of the asset is 20 years into 2 years have passed, that is 32,000. So now your carrying value carrying value as on 31st March 2013 is goodwill is 80,000 and other asset is 2,88,000. So total carrying value of the entire CGU is 3,68,000. Now there are indicators of impairment, hence we'll have to do impairment testing. So recoverable value, which is given to us of the entire CGU as on 31st March, is 2,12,000. So here your carrying value is more than the recoverable value. Hence the asset is impaired by what value? 3,68,000 minus 2,12,000. So asset is impaired by value of 1,56,000. Now this 1,56,000 has to be allocated in some ratio. First, the entire amount will be written off against goodwill. Goodwill you have of 80,000. So entire goodwill will be written off, and the remaining and the balancing will be written off against the other asset. That is 1,56,000 you have to write off. 80,000 aapne goodwill mein se write off kar diya. Rest everything has to be written off against other asset. So now what is the carrying value, revised carrying value, you can say, after impairment? As on 31st March 2013, carrying value, goodwill will be nil and your asset will be at 2,12,000. Are we clear? Now, this is the value that is on 31st March 2013 after considering impairment loss and everything. Now, after 2 years, the government has lifted the ban, which shows there are some indicators of reversal of impairment, which indicates there will be improvement in the service potential and the asset will be able to generate revenue. So now hence we should follow the procedures jo apan reversal ke liye record karte hain. Further, impairment of goodwill you cannot reverse. There will be no separate workings done for goodwill. So now, as on 31st March 2013, the carrying value which you had after impairment is 2,12,000. Correct? Again, 2 years have passed, to depreciation hoga. 2,12,000 divided by 18. 2 years have passed. Now more 18 years are left into 2. That is 23,556. So now, as on 31st March 2015, what is the ledger balance? 31st March 15, after considering impairment, depreciation, what is the ledger balance? Is 1,88,444. Okay. मतलब वी हैव टू चेंज दिस कैरिंग वैल्यू. अभी अगर अपने को इंपेयरमेंट को रिवर्स भी करना है, वी हैव टू इंक्रीज दिस. और चलो लेट्स सी. सो व्हाट इज फर्स्ट थिंग वी कैलकुलेट, व्हाट इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ कैरिंग वैल्यू इग्नोरिंग इंपेयरमेंट. अगर आप इंपेयरमेंट हुआ ही नहीं होता तो कैरिंग वैल्यू क्या होता? सो एज ऑन 31st March 2013 कैरिंग वैल्यू स्टिल वुड हैव बीन 2,88,000. इफ यू गो एज ऑन 31st March, if there were no impairment, the carrying value would have been 2,88,000. Then again 2 years have passed. So you would have depreciated the asset. That is 2,88,000 divided by 18 into 2. That comes to 32,000. So the carrying value, which max to max aap bata sakte ho after impairment ke baad, you can max to max show carrying value of only 2,56,000. But we also see the recoverable value. What is the recoverable value? They have given the value in use is 3,04,000 and fair value call as cost to disposal, that is net selling price, is 2,90,000. So whichever is higher, in this case this is 3,04,000. So now कितना रिवर्स कर सकते हैं अपन? हाउ मच इज द अमाउंट दैट वी कैन रिवर्स? आइडियली हाउ मच इंपेयरमेंट अपन ने किया था? 1,56,000 अपन ने इंपेयरमेंट लॉस किया था. बट वी कैन नॉट रिवर्स द एंटायर थिंग. कितना रिवर्स कर पाएंगे? हियर द वैल्यू एज ऑन 31st March 2015, इसको वी कैन इंक्रीज इधर टू 2,56,000 और वी कैन इंक्रीज टू 3,04,000, whichever is lower. Why? Because अगर आप बोल रहे हो कि सर इंक्रीज द कैरिंग वैल्यू टू 2,56,000, दैट्स नॉट एन इश्यू, वी विल इंक्रीज टू 2,56,000. बट यू आर सेइंग कि लेट्स इंक्रीज द एंटायर कैरिंग वैल्यू. हाउ मच एवर इज द इंपेयरमेंट लॉस? So you will say that how much impairment loss we had already earlier record. We had recorded 1,56,000 impairment. Can we add the entire amount? If we add 1,56,000 to 1,88,444, total value ho jayega 3,44,444. This value you cannot reverse the entire thing only because सबसे बड़ी बात तो यू कैन ओनली रिकवर 3,04,000, उससे ज्यादा वैल्यू बता भी नहीं सकते. एंड इफ यू वांट टू शो मोर देन, अगर आप 3,44,000 बता रहे हो कंपेयर टू कैरिंग वैल्यू यू आर शोइंग, यू आर ट्राइंग टू शो दिस अपवर्ड रिवैल्यूएशन. ऐसा नहीं होता. व्हाट इज आवर रिवर्सल प्रिंसिपल? दैट जो भी अपना वैल्यू है आफ्टर कंसिडरिंग डेप्रिसिएशन इंपेयरमेंट लॉस, वी कैन इंक्रीज इट मैक्स टू द वैल्यू ऑफ कैरिंग वैल्यू इग्नोरिंग इंपेयरमेंट, कैरिंग वैल्यू इग्नोरिंग इंपेयरमेंट or recoverable value whichever is lower. So in our case, since the amount which is lower is 2,56,000, so the max impairment loss we can reverse is maximum permissible ledger. So max you can show the asset. Ye asset ko aap max to max kya value pe bata sakte ho, whichever is lower. The max you can show it at 2,56,000. Right now the asset in its book is at 1,88,444. आप उसको 2,50,000 तक लेके जा सकते हो. So reversal of impairment will be 2,56,000 minus 1,88,444. So the max reversal you can show is 67,556. I agree, आपकी इच्छा होगी कि सर पूरा का पूरा रिवर्स करें, पर पूरा का पूरा रिवर्स नहीं कर सकते. पूरा का रिवर्स करने जाएंगे तो विल एंड अप शोइंग एट 3,44,000. ये तो नहीं रिकवरेबल वैल्यू है. अगर आपने ये वैल्यू बता दिया, इनडायरेक्टली यू आर डूइंग अपवर्ड रिवैल्यूएशन व्हिच इज नॉट अलाउड. सो इफ योर असेट लेजर बैलेंस इज 1,88,444, द मैक्स आप अपने असेट का बैलेंस बता सकते हो विच या तो कैरिंग वैल्यू इग्नोरिंग इंपेयरमेंट और रिकवरेबल वैल्यू विच एवर इज लोअर. एंड मैक्स योर कैरिंग वैल्यू कैन बी शोड एट 2,56,000. हेंस द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट्स विल बी रिवर्स्ड. अभी क्लियर? चलो ग्रेट. Let's come on to next illustration. Illustration number 13. Illustration number 13. A machine has suffered physical damage but is still working. मतलब impairment के indicators है, although not as well as before it was damaged. The machine fair value less cost of disposal is less than its carrying amount. The machine's fair value less cost of disposal is less than its carrying amount. The machine does not generate independent cash flow. The smallest identifiable group of asset that includes the machine and generate cash flow that are largely independent of the cash flow from the other asset is the production line to which machine belongs. Machine akela to cash flow generate nahi kar payega. So we look at the CGU जापे वो जाके he'll contribute. That is the it belongs to the production line in which that machine belongs. So machine belongs to that production line. So any impairment testing will be done for CGU. The recoverable amount of production line shows that the production line taken as a whole is not impaired. The whole production line is not impaired. So assumption one, budget forecast approved by management reflect no commitment of management to change the replace machine. So let's do the same sum but with numbers. So suppose you have a machine A, okay, whose carrying value is 40 and net selling price is 36, but we don't have value in use because it does not generate cash flow. So whenever you want to calculate impairment but we cannot calculate recoverable value, so apan jate next possible thing, that is the CGU. This machine belongs to one production line jiska sum jo CGU ka value is 100. So now a net selling price is say 120, value in use is 150. So what will be the recoverable value? Recoverable value will be whichever is higher, that is 150. So here what you will say, though the machine is impaired but since the CGU is not impaired, there will be no impairment loss. So when do we have to go to CGU? जब अपने पास ये option available नहीं है, because we cannot take this as zero. Zero नहीं ले सकते because value है वो generate कर रहा है, but it is generating in it is generating not independently but in dependent. So now what to do? In this case आप CGU में shift होते हो. So what is the first thing they have first case? budget forecast approved by management reflect no commitment of the management to replace the machine. Management is not intending to replace the machine. So आपको कभी भी मालूम भी नहीं पड़ेगा value in use कितना होगा. You know the net selling price. तो आप CGO में जाओगे. Now what is different in this question is this assumption 2. Budget forecast which are approved by management reflect a commitment of the management to replace the machine and sell it in near future. Cash flows from the continuing use of machine until its disposal are estimated to be negligible. Now, हमेशा why do we move to CGU? Because अपने पास value in use का problem होता था. अभी if the management is committed कि that we will replace the machine, तो you can say कि value in use तो actually zero है. This is negligible. Now, if you have net selling price, आपके पास value in use है. You will never move to CGU. आप उस मशीन का impairment directly कर सकते हो. Why? Because इधर management ने बोला है we will replace. तो the moment you want to replace, अभी आप value news निकाल सकते हो that आप use ही नहीं करने वाले. You will replace it या you will sell it. तो जो भी value आएगा वो आपका zero ही रहने वाला है. Net selling price is 30. So whichever is higher in this, that is 36. Now this is actually the recoverable value जो आप compare करोगे with the carrying value 40. So hence you can say that there is an impairment loss of 40 minus 36, that is 4 rupees. So what is happening? Again, just going through the same basic, we do impairment of individual machines, but in case if any machine we are not able to find recoverable value, so we go to the next option, upon CGU ka dikhte. In the first case, management replace karne ko ready nahi tha. So we never know कि asset को अपन ठीक करेंगे या अपन को use करने वाले भी. We can never come to a conclusion. Hence we moved to the CGU. The moment we shifted to CGU, CGU was never impaired. So in case the CGU is never impaired, even though the machine is impaired, there will be no impairment entries passed. But in second case, since the management is ready to replace, so now you know कि value news they have clearly mentioned is negligible. You have net selling price, आपको recoverable value मिल जाएगा. The moment you find recoverable value, you can directly compare with carrying value and calculate impairment. So let's look at the solution. So it's a theoretical question, but we have taken it in numbers. Let's look at the answer. Come on page number of your solution book, page number 5.8. So in the assumption 1, what are they trying to say? In case the management does not intend to replace the machine, it is important to calculate the receivable value of the damaged machine based on its net selling price as well as value in use. As the value in use cannot be determined for the individual machine, impairment was to be tested at CGU level. As the CGU is not impaired, there would be no impairment loss even for the individual asset. That we agree. In assumption to what happened, the management is committed ki nahi humko machine change karna hi hai. So now the cash flow generated, if any, from using the machine would be negligible. Hence the recoverable value of machine A will be correctly represented by net selling price. Because abhi aap bol sakte ho ki value new zero hai. So whatever is the recoverable value is nothing but your net selling price. Hence we can directly do impairment testing by comparing the carrying value and the net selling price of machine, and CGU level ka impairment testing is not required. Additionally, in case this asset satisfy the condition under Ind AS 105, Ind AS 105 is non-current asset held for sale, then we would classify this PPE or jo bhi hai, will classify it as a non-current asset held for sale. Are we clear? Great. Now, let's go to the next concept, that is unallocable corporate asset. We have done corporate asset, we have seen how we can allocate the corporate asset, but there's one more thing, that is unallocable corporate asset. What do you mean by unallocable corporate asset? See, now there can be situation. अपन बोलते corporate asset है. Yes, we will allocate it in the different CGU based on some carrying value. This is what we used to do. But what if there are some corporate asset which you cannot allocate? आपको try, आप चाहते हो तो भी आप allocate नहीं कर पाओगे. Example. See now Nestle. Nestle is a company which has so many products of FMCG. Bahut sare product hai. Now there's a head office of Nestle which is being used by all the products. Maggi, different biscuits, then you have soaps and bahut sare products एवरीवन इज यूजिंग द हेड ऑफिस. इन सच केस आप कभी भी एलोकेट नहीं कर पाओगे कि इन केस द मैगी इज इंपेयर्ड ऑल्सो यू विल नेवर गेट टू नो हाउ मच इज द एलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट असेट बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट अनएलोकेबल. नेस्ले इज वन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. इतना पूरे वो हेड ऑफिस को ऑल द प्रोडक्ट्स आर यूजिंग, जितने भी कंपनी प्रोडक्ट्स बना रही एवरीवन इज यूजिंग. इन सच केस यू वोंट बी एबल टू एलोकेट द कॉर्पोरेट असेट. सो दे कैन बी अ सिचुएशन वेयर देयर आर अनएलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट असेट. दैट इज पॉसिबल दैट सम कॉर्पोरेट असेट कैन बी यूज एज अ कॉमन सीजीयू बट वी आर अनएबल टू एलोकेट क्लियरली. दिस इज यूज फॉर कॉमन कैश जनरेशन बट अपन एलोकेट नहीं कर पाएंगे. सो इन सच केस वॉट टू डू. In such case, we do two tire impairment testing. What is two tire impairment testing? That is, first we calculate impairment loss for all the smaller CGU. After allocating carry CGU, again carrying value of कॉर्पोरेट असेट विच आर एलोकेबल वो भी ले लो, गुडविल भी ले लो, सब ले लो. कैलकुलेट द इंपेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ स्मॉलर सीजीयू एंड इग्नोर द अनएलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट असेट. सो वी डू द सम. नॉर्मली हाउ वी डू, वी टेक ऑल द मशीन जितने भी थे सीजीयू में, वी टेक गुडविल, वी टेक कॉर्पोरेट एलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट असेट, एवरीथिंग. We first do impairment loss for all the smaller CGU, but we'll ignore unallocable asset because वो allocate नहीं हो सकते. So this is a first tier of testing. Second, unallocable corporate asset can be allocated to a larger CGU. Larger CGU मतलब क्या? पूरा कंपनी का देखो आप. अगर इनकेस अनएलोकेबल है विच यू कैनॉट एलोकेट टू अ पर्टिकुलर सीजीयू, तो यू लुक फॉर द एंटिटी एज अ होल. इन सच केस इफ एनी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस, अभी अगर ये स्टेज पे जाके सेकेंड टायर पे जाके कुछ भी टाइप का इंपेयरमेंट लॉस आया, एवरीथिंग विल बी बोर्न बाय अनएलोकेबल असेट. वाई? बिकॉज इधर जो भी मशीन थे ए बी सी डी, इन लोगों ने अपना जो भी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस था वो ऑलरेडी अब्सॉर्ब कर दिया है. नाउ दिस असेट आर ऑलरेडी एट द कैरिंग वैल्यू रिकवरिंग या रिकवरेबल वैल्यू विच एवर इज लेस, दे आर ऑलरेडी एट दैट वैल्यू. नाउ अभी ये लोग और कुछ भी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस ले नहीं पाएंगे. तो इफ देर इज एनी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस एट अनकॉर्पोरेबल, इफ देर इज एनी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस एट सेकेंड टायर टेस्टिंग ऑफ अनएलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट लॉस, द एंटायर लॉस विल बी टेकन बाय दिस पर्टिकुलर अनएलोकेबल कॉर्पोरेट असेट. आर वी क्लियर? ग्रेट. Now, there's one last concept which we are left to do, that is appropriate allocation ratio for allocable corporate asset. Say, Nestle has a corporate asset which is of carrying value 100, whose life is 4 years. Now Nestle, say Nestle has 4 CGU, okay? So you have carrying value of A, B, C and D. You have carrying value of 10, 20, 30 and 40, and you have life of CGU. Aapko CGU ka life diya hai. A ka is 1 years, 2 years, 3 years, or one second, we'll take it as 4, 3, 2 and 1. Now, the question is, in what ratio should the corporate asset be allocated in two different CGU? In what ratio should the carrying value of the corporate asset be distributed amongst different CGU? Now, it's a very simple thing. Ki jis CGU ka carrying value zyada rahega, that will absorb most of the corporate asset. But again, which the CGU, जिसका life सबसे ज्यादा है, वो 4 साल तक corporate asset use करने वाला है, तो he will also take the most of the carrying value. So now, what the institute says, कि आप दोनों को important weightage दो. What you do is, you allocate you allocate the corporate asset based on time based weighted average. Time based weighted average मतलब क्या? Carrying value into life of CGU. मतलब if the 100 का जो corporate asset है, you take in the ratio of 40:60:60:40. That is, you are considering कि जिसका life ज्यादा है, जिसका life ज्यादा है, but if the carrying value is less, even that will be taken care, and जिसका and the CGU which will be using it only for 1 year, but has a heavy carrying value, even proper corporate asset will be allocated. So in this case, the allocation will be based on carrying value into life of CGU. Now, what if life is not given only? Suppose this column is not given to us, then no issues only. We can directly allocate the entire corporate asset into on the ratio of carrying value. Correct? So what will you do? You will allocate the entire thing in the ratio of carrying value. What if there's one more possibility? The life of corporate asset is only 2 years. Life of corporate asset is only 2 years. So in such case, what can you do? Now, if life of the corporate asset is only 2 years, then we ignore the life of CGU wala column and take the maximum type corporate asset use hoga. That means, so if you have A, B, C, D, carrying value is 10, 20, 30, 40. Life of CGU was how much? 4, 3, 2, 1. Correct? Now, if the life of the corporate asset is only 2 years, then there is no point in taking it 4. Isko bhi aapko 2 lena padega, isko bhi aapko 2 lena padega. Because, agar life hi 2 years hai, they won't be able to use the CGU A, we won't be able to use it for more 2 years, or CGU B won't be able to use for 1 year. But C will be 2 years, so 2 years hi rahega. If D is using for 1 year, you cannot make it to 2. If it is going to use for 1 year, toh 1 year ke liye rahega. So hence, the corporate life, which has life of only 2 years, then we ignore the CGU column as maximum time corporate asset will be used for maximum time 2 saal ke liye use ho sakta hai. So aapko jo bhi divide karna hai, you have to divide it in this ratio. Are we clear? Great. Now let's come on to illustration number 14. It's an RTP question. Illustration number 14 is an RTP question. It's a very important question. Now, ABC Limited has 3 cash generating units A, B and C. The carrying amount as on 31st March 2011 is as follow. Aapko diya hua hai CGU A ka carrying amount is 500, life is 10 years, B ka 750, 20 years, C ka carrying amount is 1100 and 20 years. ABC Limited has also 2 corporate assets and they have a remaining life of 20 years. Corporate asset ka life 20 years hai. So there are 2 types of corporate asset, that is corporate asset X, jiska carrying value hai 600. The carrying amount of X can be allocated on a reasonable basis, that is pro rata basis, to the individual CGU. We have just seen ki in case, how do we allocate the corporate asset in different CGU? Apan hamesha weighted average lete, time based weighted average. So in our case, given that apne ko bola hai, X should be allocated on a corporate asset jo X hai, that should be allocated on a reasonable basis. So if 600 is the cost of the corporate asset, we have carrying value of A, B and C, that is 500, 750 and 1100. We have life kitna hai? 10 20 20. See, here the life of the corporate asset is also 20 years, so issue nahi hai, we don't have to do any other working. So what is the weighted average? What ratio can be divided is 5,000:15,000:22,000. To make the ratio more easier, you can directly say 5:15:22. Are we clear? Now, corporate asset Y, that is 200. They are saying the carrying amount of Y cannot be allocated on a reasonable basis to the individual cash generating unit. Now this is an unallocable corporate asset which we cannot allocate to the different CGU. So this would, so now again we'll have to do two-tier testing, and as the corporate asset Y is unallocable, it would not form part of the carrying value of A, B and C. Are we clear? So now what is the procedure if you want to do impairment testing? First, we'll have to do two-tier impairment testing because we have unallocable corporate asset also. So now, first tier testing, this will say tier 1 testing, you can say. We do this tier 1 testing for all the CGU, all the smaller CGU. So impairment testing for smaller CGUs. That is A, B, C, including X, जो अपने allocate किया है. So let's do the impairment testing. The first, what is the carrying value? These are all different CGUs, CGU A, B and C. That is 500, 750, 1100. Please don't make a mistake of writing here X because X is not a CGU. X to is a corporate asset which you have allocated in the respective CGU. Aap idhar X likh doonge, you are trying to say ki even that is a separate CGU. That is not the case. So carrying value, that is individual asset plus allocable corporate asset. Allocable corporate asset abhi apne kiya hai. Upar what ratio may we have to divide? 5 is to 15 is to 22. So on your calc, take 600 into 5 and calculate the ratio. So this comes to allocable comes to 71. This comes to 214 and this comes to 315. Are we clear? So what is the total carrying value of A? It's 571, 964 and 1415. Now, in the question, we have been given recoverable value as on 31st March 2011 is as follows. For CGU A, the recoverable value is 600, for B is 900 and for C is 1400. Hence, now we have to check if it's impaired. Carrying value is lower than recoverable value for CGU A. Hence, no impairment. In this case, there is an impairment of 64 rupees. And in this case also, there is an impairment of 15. So, now whatever is the impairment loss, we have to allocate. So, allocation of impairment loss. Here we don't have goodwill to directly, whatever is the impairment loss will be taken by individual asset and corporate asset, correct? So AK case mein toh hai nil, so not an issue. Here now we have to allocate in the ratio. So 64 into what is the total value of the asset? Individual asset is 750 into 750 total divided by 964. That is the value of total asset that will go in the individual, that is 50, and 64 into 214 divided by 64 into 214 divided by 964. This will come to 14. Correct? Similarly, we'll do the same working for CGU C also. That is the loss of 15 into what is the total carrying value of individual asset is 1100. And total value 1415, and how much you will allocate to corporate asset? Again 15 into 315 divided by 1415. So this comes to 12 and this comes to 3. So we have, what we have done is we have allocated the impairment loss to all the smaller CGU. Now corporate asset, we are done with level 1, that is tier 1 impairment testing is done. Now let's go to impairment testing for larger CGU, that is second tier testing. So now that corporate asset Y, which was not allocable to any of the smaller CGU, what will we say? Pura company CGU hai. So now if you, I want to calculate the carrying value of the entire company, what will I take? I will take CGU A, I will take CGU B, I will take CGU C, I will take corporate asset and I will take corporate asset Y. Correct? So this is the entire value. This will be the entire value of the entire company. So what is the value of CGU A? So what is the value? That is 500. Correct? CGU A is value is 500. What is the value of CGU B? CGUB, you will say 750 was the value and there's an impairment loss of 50. So you will say 700 is the value of CGUB. What is the value of CGUC? You will say 1100 was the carrying individual value and 12 is the impairment. That is how much? 1088. What is the value of corporate asset? You will say 600 was the value in which minus 14 and minus 13 is impaired. That is 600 minus 14 minus 3. You will say 583 is the value of corporate asset. And corporate asset Y which is not impaired, that is 200. So total carrying value of of the entire company comes to 323071. This you can alternatively also calculate. Aap directly bhi calculate kar sakte ho. You can directly say the value of CGUA including corporate asset is 500 plus 71, that is 571. Value of CGUB including corporate asset is 964 minus impairment loss of 64, impairment loss of 900, and CGUC is 1415 minus 15, that is 1400. Corporate asset jo allocable tha aapne already idhar consider kar diya hai, and corporate asset Y that is 200. Again the value comes to 307. This is the alternate way also you can calculate. So now carrying value is 3071. Recoverable value directly diya hai, dekho aapko table mein diya hai. Recoverable value as on 31st March on is as follow. ABC Limited, the whole company recoverable value is 3200. Now since here the carrying value is less than the recoverable value, hence there is no impairment. In case the entire value of the company, recoverable value of the company would be say 3000. In such case, there would be an impairment loss of 71, which would directly go to the unallocable corporate asset. Pura ka pura unallocable corporate asset ko jata. That is 200 minus 71. Because CGU, ABC are already at their recoverable value or carrying value, whichever is lower. They won't be able to take more impairment. Jo bhi impairment hona tha, wo ho gaya hai. Toh abhi jiske paas baki hai, who can take the impairment loss? That will be unallocable corporate asset. So why do you think, why this two-step impairment testing is required? Why can we do it saath mein only? Only because, abhi dekho, ye case mein kya hua tha? Carrying value was 3071. Recoverable value was 3200. Original recoverable value was 3200. So what you would say, since the CGU is not impaired, none of the machines are impaired. But actually if you see, there is an impairment loss of 64 and 15. So if you don't do two tire, you would have directly done for the company, and at the company level you would never understand that there is an impairment loss, because carrying value is 307. Jo positive or negative, that will cover the difference. So you will never figure out there is an impairment loss. Hence we have to do two level impairment testing. At first you will understand what is the impairment at each CGU level, and then for the company as a whole. Are we clear? Great. Now let's come on to the next question. Next question, illustration number 15. It is a very, very, very important question. This covers all the concepts jo bhi impairment ka apne kiya tha. So before the exam, if you have to do one sum from impairment, you have to do this illustration. It's an RTP question and they have asked in many a times. So this question is very, very important. So before exam, please do this sum. Mark kar lo isko important. Let's read the question. Alia Limited is a manufacturing company which deals into manufacturing of cold drinks and beverages. It is having various plants across India. There is machinery A in the Baroda plant which is used for the purpose of bottling. There is one more machinery which is machinery B clubbed with machinery A. Machinery A can individually have an output and can also sell it independently in the open market. Machine B cannot be sold in isolation and without clubbing with machine A, it cannot produce output as well. That means you have two machines that is machine A and machine B, they have clearly mentioned that they are a part of one CGU only, because machine A cannot independently generate output. It cannot independently generate output, and it depends on machine A. They have clearly mentioned this. Now, the company considers this group of particular asset as a CGU and an inventory amounting to rupees 2 lakh and goodwill amounting to 1 lakh 50 lakh is included in this CGU. Now comes the twist. That in CGU, there are not only machines, but they also have goodwill. They also have inventory. Now, inventory to never gets covered under impairment. We have already discussed ki impairment mein kabhi bhi inventory aata nahi, because the accounting standard 2 and inventory already has impairment principle. The whole principle of valuation of inventory, cost of NRV, whichever is lower, it already caters to the impairment principle. Then why inventory over here? Let's take an example. Say you have, you know, there's an H&M, okay? H&M in Phoenix. Now, one day H&M decides to wind up its operations in India and move back to its original country. Now, H&M ka itna pura area hai, samjho property bhi uska hi hai. So what it will do, since the company is decided to close the shop, they will do impairment testing. Now, H&M, when it tries to do impairment testing, they will be carrying value and you'll have to cover it, compare it with the recoverable value. Recoverable value matlab kya? Net selling price and value in use. Now, in the H&M shop, in the jo bhi H&M ka hai, they will be having clothes also. Of course, stock to rahega hi andar. They will have many clothes, pura inventory pada rahega. Now, I'll tell you a simple thing. This is the building and this is the inventory. If you see, they both are interrelated. You cannot sell the building. Dekho, if you are trying to calculate value in use, so building won't help you to generate revenue, but the stock inside it will help you generate the revenue. And without building, aap kidhar bechonge? Without, if there's no building, how will you sell the inventory? So they both are interdependent on each other. So jabhi bhi recoverable value diya rahega, the person who is quoting the recoverable value, the person who is quoting the net selling price or value in use, he will include the value of inventory also. But now, if our carrying value, aap bolte ho inventory nahi lenge, to one-to-one comparison won't be possible only. Because the recoverable value not only includes the value of building, but also includes the value of inventory. But in the carrying value, you decide ki how come inventory possible nahi hai. But you see, inventory is a part of, jaise machine ek CGU ka part hai, inventory is also a part of CGU, jo aapko carrying value mein lena padega. The only difference will be that this won't be impaired. Ye already cost NRV se lower mein hoga, this won't be impaired. So, in case aapko sab mein bola hai ki the CGU not only is machine A and B, but also includes goodwill and also includes inventory. Inventory can be a part of CGU, because agar kuch stock hoga, to samne wala jabhi bhi price quote karega, he will include the amount of inventory also, because they both are interrelated. Value in use kaise aayega? Building bech ke to alag baat hai, but value in use building bechna to matlab business close, going concern affect karna ho gaya. If you want to generate the value will come from the inventory. The only thing is ki inventory won't be impaired in this case. Are we clear? So what do you understand? In carrying value will include all the machine, will include inventory also, and will include goodwill also. Now, the goodwill amount is 1.5. So we'll take the figures later. Let's read the whole question. Now, machinery A was purchased on 1st April 2013 for 10 lakhs and residual value is 50,000. Machinery B was purchased on 1st April 15 for 5 lakhs with no residual value. The useful life of both machine A and B is 10 years. The company expects following cash flow in the next 5 years pertaining to machinery A. The incremental borrowing rate of company is 10%. So you have been given the cash flows in order to calculate value in use for machinery A. That is all 5 years ka value you have been given. On 31st March 2018, the professional values have estimated, the professional valuer have estimated that the current market value of machinery, that is the net selling price, is 7 lakhs. The valuation fee was 1 lakh. There is a need to dismantle the machinery before delivering it to the buyer. Dismantling cost is 1 lakh 50. Specialized packing cost would be 25,000 and legal fees would be 75,000. Each of three lines what I have read, this is talking about your net selling price. If you wanted to sell the machinery, 7 lakh ka kharcha aayega minus whatever is the cost to sell, that is the incremental selling cost. Ki aap bechoge to ye cost aapko lagne wala hai. So the three lines are talking about net selling price. You can make a calculation and write about net selling price. The inventory has been valued in accordance with Ind AS 2. Recoverable value of CGU is 10 lakhs as on 31st March 2018. In the next year, company has done the assessment of recoverability of CGU and found that value of CGU is 11 lakhs. Wapas kuch reversal bhi hone wala hai. That is on 31st March 2019. The recoverable value of machine A is 4 lakh 50 and combined machine A and B is 7 lakh 60 as on 31st March 2019. You are required to compare the impairment loss on CGU and carrying value of each asset after charging impairment loss for the year ended 31st March 18, providing with all the relevant working notes to arrive at such calculation. Compute the prospective depreciation for the next year 18-19 on the above asset and compute the carrying value of CGU as on 31st March 2019. So full-fledged firm will be covering all the concepts. Hence, this question is very important. The bigger the question, the more information they have given. So it becomes more easier for us. So how to start with the question? So first thing, what have they asked you? Calculate the impairment loss as on 31st March 2018. So we have to calculate impairment loss as on 31st March 2018. Matlab, pehle apne ko carrying value nikalna padega as on 31st March 2018 ka and recoverable value, that is nothing but NSP and value in use as on 31st March 18. So first let's try to remove carrying value as on 31st March 2018. So carrying value, machinery A ka kitna rahega? Machinery A, you have bought it for 10 lakhs, correct? Machine A aapne 10 lakhs ke liye buy kiya. Now you bought it, you bought machine A on 1st April. They have given the year. Machine A was bought on 1st April 2013. We are in 2018. 5 years have passed. So depreciation will be 10 lakhs. There's a salvage value also 50,000 ka. Divide by 10 years into 5 years. So what is the amount of depreciation? lakhs divided by salvage value, that is 50,000 divided by 10 years, per year depreciation will come to 95,000 into 5. So basically depreciation is 4,75,000. So machine A written down value is coming to 5,25,000, correct? Now we will find the written down value for machine B. Machine B was also purchased for the cost of 5 lakhs, but machine B was purchased in the year, look in the question, machine B was purchased in the year 2015, so 3 years have only passed. So depreciation, less depreciation, again the value, the life of the asset is 10 years and 3, there is no scrap value into 3 years. So this will come to 1 lakh 50. So written down value, machine B written down value is nothing but 2 lakhs, correct? Sorry, it's 3,50,000. Now, after that, in this particular CGU, you have inventory also. Inventory kitne ka hai? 2 lakhs ka inventory hai. And then you have goodwill also, that is of 1,50,000. So, the total carrying value of the CGU, the total carrying value of CGU and 31st March 18 is nothing but, there are comprises of 4 things. The total carrying value comprises of 4 things, that is machine A, machine B, inventory and goodwill. That is, the total comes to 12,25,000, correct? So the first thing for impairment, we had to calculate carrying value, jo apne nikala hai, 12,25,000, correct? Now रिकवरेबल वैल्यू दे हैव डायरेक्टली गिवन अस, डायरेक्ट रिकवरेबल वैल्यू अपने को कितना दिया हुआ है इन लोगों ने, कैरिंग वैल्यू इज 2,12,25,000 एज़ वी डिस्कस्ड, एंड रिकवरेबल वैल्यू ऑफ द एंटायर सीजीयू कितना है, रिकवरेबल वैल्यू दे हैव डायरेक्टली गिवन दैट इज 10 लाख. सो इज देयर एन इंपेयरमेंट और नो, कैरिंग वैल्यू इज मोर देन द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू, हेंस देयर इज एन इंपेयरमेंट लॉस, इंपेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ 2,25,000, करेक्ट. सो नाउ वी हैव टू एलोकेट दिस लॉस ऑफ 2,25,000, को कैसे एलोकेट करेंगे, वी हैव टू एलोकेट दिस लॉस ऑफ 2,25,000. सो इट्स अंडरस्टूड द फर्स्ट थिंग, द फर्स्ट थिंग जो रिकवरेबल लॉस, जो भी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस का बेयर करेगा विल बी गुडविल. वी ऑलरेडी हैव अ गुडविल ऑफ 1,50,000. The entire goodwill will be write off against the impairment loss, and rest will be given to other asset. Other asset मतलब कौन से, machine A and machine B, but there will be no impairment loss given to inventory. So if out of 2,25,000, 1,50,000 is given to goodwill, 75,000 is the value of the जो other asset को देंगे. So normally what we would do, directly अपन क्या करेंगे, carrying ratio में divide कर देंगे. So 75,000 into 5,25,000 divided by 8,75,000, correct? And 75,000 into 3,50,000 divided by 8,75,000. And you will say ki machine A is impaired by 45,000 and machine B is impaired by 30,000, correct? This is wrong. How can you allocate entire 45,000 to machine A or machine B without checking whether actually ये लोग impair हुए, maybe impair हुए रहेंगे, maybe A पूरा 45 से impair नहीं होगा, कि थोड़े से impair हुआ होगा. So we'll have to check कि machine A and machine B are actually ये लोग impair हुए कि नहीं हुए. तो first let's check for machine A. ऐसे directly you cannot allocate the impairment loss to the particular asset. So what we do is for machine A, we know the carrying value कितना है, 5,25,000, correct? And we compare it by the recoverable value. Recoverable value is how much? We have net selling price and we have value in use. Okay? Now, net selling price kitna hai? They have clearly mentioned the current market se aapko kitna paisa aega. You can get max to max 7 lakh. But you will have some selling expense also, jo aapko specially incur karna padega if you sell the asset. That is, you have to less dismantling cost, आपको less करना पड़ेगा. This is all the, so fair value minus less cost, less estimated selling price, yeah, minus cost to disposal. Then there is a specialized packing cost which you'll have to do, that is of 25,000. Then you'll have to also incur legal fees of 75,000. So what is the net selling price आपके हाथ में आएगा? What is the net selling price which you will get? That is 4,50,000. So when we do net selling price, what is the formula net selling price ka? What is the formula of net selling price? That is fair value, ya jo bhi apne ko selling price milega, jo bhi apne ko selling price milega, minus estimated selling expense. Now, what do you mean by estimated selling expense? Matlab incremental expense that entity would incur agar wo bechne niklega. In our case, agar tumne dekha ek aur cheez tha, valuation fees of 1 lakh. Now this valuation fees has nothing to do with the sale. Aapne valuation karwa diya, usko paisa de diya. This is nothing ki agar aap nahi bhi beche to bhi aapko cost lagne wala tha, aap becho to bhi cost lagne wala tha. This is not incremental selling expense. The valuation fees is dependent upon the professional valuation and not dependent upon sale. आपको sale नहीं करना तो भी आप valuation करने ही वाले थे. And as the valuation is already done, आपने already पैसा दे दिया है, irrespective of the sale, hence valuation is not considered in the net selling expense. इधर आप जो net selling expense करते हो, this are only the incremental selling expense. मतलब ऐसा selling expense which you will incur to sell. अगर आप नहीं बेचने, अगर आप selling नहीं करोगे तो वो खर्चा होगा भी नहीं. Are we clear? So your net selling price comes to how much? This comes to 4,50,000. Value in use. We have been given cash flows. अपने को easily लोगों ने cash flows दिए हैं. वी कैन डायरेक्टली कैलकुलेट कैश फ्लोज के हेल्प से द वैल्यू इन यूज कितना है. ईयर वन, ईयर वन टू थ्री, देयर आर फाइव ईयर्स, करेक्ट. कैश इनफ्लो कितना दिया आपको, 1,50,000. देन यू हैव बीन गिवन 1 लाख, देन यू हैव बीन गिवन अगेन 1 लाख, देन यू कैन, देन यू हैव बीन गिवन 1,50,000, और इधर भी आपको 1,50,000 दिया है, करेक्ट. डिस्काउंटिंग रेट दे हैव गिवन, दैट इज 10%, बोला हुआ है क्लियरली. जब तक इंक्रीमेंटल बोर्डिंग रेट ऑफ द कंपनी इज 10%, सो डिस्काउंटिंग रेट इज 0.9090, 0.8264, 0.7513, 0.6830 and 0.6209. So present value of cash inflows, once you do the calculation, this will come to 136,350, 82,640, 75,130, 102,450 and 93,100. Calculation can be done by you. So what is the value in use? Value in use comes to 489,705. So in your calculation, जब आप चेक कर रहे थे कि एक्चुअली मशीने इम्पेयर है कि नहीं, सो वॉट विल बी डू इज वैल्यू इन यूज कितना है आपका, 489,705. सो विच एवर इज हायर, वॉट इज हायर, 489,705. सो येस देर इज इंपेयरमेंट, वी आर नॉट डिनाइंग द फैक्ट, इंपेयरमेंट है. कितने का इंपेयरमेंट है, 5,25,000 माइनस 489,705. इंपेयरमेंट इज ओनली टू द एक्सटेंट ऑफ 35,295. आप क्या कर रहे थे बिना देखे, व्हेन यू एलोकेट द इंपेयरमेंट लॉस यू आर गोइंग टू एलोकेट 45,000. बट इफ द क्वेश्चन हैज डेटा एंड यू कैन प्रूव दैट मशीने इतने से इंपेयर नहीं हुआ है, पर मशीने खाली इतने से इंपेयर हुआ है, सो व्हाट विल चेंज, इधर क्या आ जाएगा, द होल कैलकुलेशन मशीन, ये पूरा कैलकुलेशन हट जाएगा. तो आउट ऑफ 75,000 मशीन ए विल गेट इंपेयर्ड बाय 35,295. मशीन ए विल गेट इंपेयर्ड बाय 295 एंड बैलेंसिंग विल गो टू मशीन बी, बिकॉज मशीन बी का आपने को डिटेल्स नहीं दिया हुआ है, सो वी कैनॉट प्रूव व्हाट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ इंपेयरमेंट या कितना इंपेयरमेंट हुआ है. हेंस द एंटायर बैलेंस, हेंस द एंटायर बैलेंस विल गो टू मशीन बी, दैट इज 39,705. आर वी क्लियर इन दिस, सबको समझाइए. सो हुआ क्या कि अपने को सीजीओ लेवल पे वी कैलकुलेटेड देयर इज इंपेयरमेंट एंड वी एलोकेटेड द एंटायर इंपेयरमेंट टू अदर एसेट इन द कैरिंग वैल्यू रेशियो, गलत हो जाएगा. पर चेक तो करो मशीन ए इंपेयर हुआ है कि नहीं हुआ है. अपन ने पूरा कैलकुलेशन किया मशीन ए, मशीन बी, ए का इंपेयरमेंट का, मशीन बी का डेटा नहीं दिया था, हेंस द एंटायर बैलेंसिंग, जो भी कैरिंग बैलेंसिंग, जो भी इंपेयरमेंट लॉस होगा, दैट विल गो टू मशीन बी. सो नाउ लेट्स लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ सीजीओ, कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ सीजीओ एज ऑन 31st March 2018 आफ्टर इंपेयरमेंट. तो अभी मशीन ए जिसका पहले वैल्यू था 5,25,000, नाउ इट इज इंपेयर्ड अप टू 35,295, तो कैरिंग वैल्यू कितना हो गया, 4,89,705. मशीन बी, मशीन बी इज 3,50,000 माइनस 39,705. So machine B is impaired at 3,10,295, correct? Then you have inventory. Inventory is never impaired because the impairment provisions are already embedded in the particular AS also. So wo kabhi bhi is AS mein impairment ka kabhi bhi inventory ka nahi aayega. And goodwill, goodwill pura ka pura impaired ho gaya hai. So you had 1,50,000, entire thing has been written off against the impairment loss, so nil. So what is the carrying value? What is the carrying value? Is 10 lakhs. So now here we are done for year 31st March 2018 अपना हो गया है. In the question क्या पूछा था, computer impairment loss on CGU and carrying value of each asset after charging impairment loss for year ending 31st March 2018 by providing the working notes. अपने 31st March 18 का पूरा बता दिए. Compute the prospective depreciation for the year 18-19 of the above asset. तो डेप्रिसिएशन कितना होगा, तो फॉर द ईयर 2018-19 दे हैव आस्क्ड अस टू कैलकुलेट डेप्रिसिएशन, चलो कर लेते. सो यू हैव मशीन ए एंड मशीन बी. मशीन ए का अभी अपन ने ऊपर कैरिंग वैल्यू कितना देखा, 4,89,705 एंड मशीन बी का कैरिंग वैल्यू इज 3,10,295. अभी वी हैव जस्ट कैलकुलेटेड, सो दिस इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू. after impairment, correct, minus depreciation. How much will the depreciation for machine A? 489,705. We'll have to calculate a new value. Minus 50,000 is the salvage value. 5 साल मशीन को हो गया है, वी हैव मोर 5 इयर्स, तो 5 इयर्स तक और डिप्रिशिएट करेंगे तो 1 ईयर का डिप्रिसिएशन विल कम टू 87,941. बट मशीन बी स्टिल हैज अ लाइफ ऑफ 7 इयर्स, सो एंड विद इट हैज नो स्क्रैप वैल्यू, सो डिवाइड बाय 7 इनटू 1 ईयर का डिप्रिसिएशन कम्स टू 44,328, करेक्ट. सो नाउ व्हाट इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू, व्हाट इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू as on 31st March 2019, considering depreciation, impairment, sub, after final figure kya aya? 401,764 and 265,967, correct. Now, again, they have given ki 2019 mein, there was kuch hua tha, there was recovery, the company has done the assessment of recoverability of CGU. Year end हुआ, कंपनी ने देखा कि अगर इंपेयरमेंट लॉस अपने किया था, इज देयर एनी चांसेस दैट द इंपेयरमेंट लॉस कैन बी रिवर्स. तो व्हाट हैव वी डन, फर्स्ट कैरिंग वैल्यू निकाल दे सीजीयू का. व्हाट इज द कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ सीजीयू? अभी अपन ने मशीन ए का ऊपर का वैल्यू देखा, मशीन ए मशीन बी, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू? मशीन ए इज 401,764, 265,967 एंड यू हैव इन्वेंटरी, गुडविल तो है नहीं अपने पास, that is nil, inventory is 2 lakh. So what is the carrying value of CGU as on 31st March 2019? This comes to 867,731, correct. Now we will compare, we will now inventory we assume ki closing bhi wahi hai, opening same hai, dono mein kuch changes nahi hua hai. Now we calculate what is the recoverable value. They have already given the recoverable value of the entire CGU is 11 lakhs. So अभी इधर क्या लग रहा है कि there is something like impairment reversal लग रहा है, there is reversal of impairment, correct. Now as the recoverable value is higher than the carrying value of CGU, there appears to be a reversal of impairment. Assuming, we always assume कुछ भी दिया नहीं है, there is an improvement in the service potential. So a reversal for impairment can be checked for machine A and B. Impairment on goodwill तो कभी भी reverse हो नहीं सकता, तो we'll have to only check it for machine A and B. Inventory तो was never impaired only. Hence, we'll only show workings of reversal of impairment for machine A and B. ठीक है? Now, what is the ledger balance after everything, after impairment? Ledger balance as on 31st March 2019, depreciation करके, impairment करके, सब कितना था? 401,764 and 265,967. Now, to reverse the impairment, अपने को कितना अपने impairment total किया था? In the first year, we recorded an impairment loss of how much? We calculated impairment loss of 2,25,000. Can we reverse the entire impairment? Actually, वो सब देखने की भी जरूरत नहीं. We know कि जो carrying value है, we can increase it only to the lower of recoverable value or carrying value, ignoring impairment. So let's calculate carrying value अगर impairment होता ही नहीं. So अगर impairment होता ही नहीं, तो उस time carrying value कितना होता था? 5,25,000 and 3,50,000, correct? फिर एक ईयर और पास हो जाता तो वापस डेप्रिसिएशन लगता. वी ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन कितना था इसका? 95,000 और इसका डेप्रिसिएशन अपन ने कैलकुलेट किया था 50,000 पर एनम. सो कैरिंग वैल्यू अगर डेप्रिसिएशन नहीं होता, सॉरी इंपेयरमेंट नहीं होता एज ऑन 31st March 2019, इट वुड बी 4,30,000 एंड इट वुड बी 3 लाख फॉर मशीनरी ए बी. देन व्हाट इज द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू? रिकवरेबल वैल्यू कितना दिया है इन लोगों ने? क्या बोला? गिवन इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट वे. द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू ऑफ मशीन ए बोला है 4,50,000 एंड कंबाइंड मशीन ए और बी का रिकवरेबल वैल्यू कंबाइन होके होता है 7,60,000. तो आई कैन इजी कैलकुलेट मशीन बी का रिकवरेबल वैल्यू, दैट इज हाउ मच, दिस इज कमिंग टू 3,10,000. नाउ व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट आई कैन शो माय लेजर बैलेंस? व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट आई कैन शो माय लेजर बैलेंस? दैट इज lower of the above two. So maximum, मैं मेरा maximum ledger balance कितना तक बता सकता हूं? In machine A, I can show it to 4 lakh 30, and in machine B, I can show it to 3 lakhs, correct? So, अभी मेरा जो भी ledger balance है 4 lakh का, I can increase the ledger balance, मतलब मैं impairment loss reverse कर सकता हूँ कितने तक का, up to I can get this amount, ये amount तक मैं मेरा maximum reversal कर सकता हूँ, और इसका भी I can get it to 3 lakh, तो what is the maximum reversal? That is 4 lakh 30 thousand minus 401,764. Maximum I can reverse is 28,236. And in machine B, maximum I can reverse is 3 lakh minus 265,967. Maximum I can reverse is 34,033. Are we clear? Maximum aap itna reverse kar sakte ho. So what is the final carrying value? अभी पूरा सम खत्म हो गया, आपने रिवर्सल भी कर दिया, यू हैव टू गिव देम द कैरिंग वैल्यू ऑन 31 मार्च 2019. सो मशीन ए हुज बैलेंस वाज 4,01,764, आपने रिवर्स कर दिया इंपेयरमेंट और यू हैव एडेड 28,230, टोटल वैल्यू कम्स टू 4,30,000, करेक्ट? यही तो अपने को मैक्सिमम बताना था ना, ये दोनों वैल्यू आने वाली है. मशीन बी, मशीन ए हो गया, वी हैव डन फॉर मशीन ए. मशीन बी इज हाउ मच? 265,967 को अपन ने रिवर्सल इंपेयरमेंट रिवर्सल से बढ़ा दिया है बाय 34,033, दैट इज 3 लाख रुपीज. इन्वेंट्री इज स्टिल एट 2 लाख, एंड गुडविल तो आपका ऐसे भी, यू कैन नॉट रिवर्स गुडविल, द गुडविल इज ऑलवेज निल. सो योर कैरिंग वैल्यू as on 31st March 2019 of the entire CGU is 9,30,000. या directly भी कर सकते थे, carrying value इतना आपको working नहीं बताना था, you knew कि maximum balance you can show 4,30,000 plus 3 lakh, and 2 lakhs inventory का था ही, तो ये ऐसे भी आपको 9,30,000 आ जाता. So this is an very important sum, we are done with the calculation. So this sum covers everything, your allocation of loss, reversal of impairment. So mark this question is very important. This is a very likely question which can come. Now let's go on to the next illustration. Illustration number 16. This is an exam November 18 exam question. A machine which was acquired by ABC Limited 15 years ago at a cost of 20 crore. Its accumulated depreciation as on 31st March 2018 was 16.6 crore. Depreciation estimate for the financial year 18-19 is 1 crore. Estimated net selling price of the machine as on 31st March 2018 was 1.2 crore, which is expected to decline 20% by end of next financial year. Its value in use has been computed at 1.4 crore as on 1st April 2018, which is expected to decrease by 30% by the end of the financial year. Assuming that other condition of the accounting standard of the impairment are satisfied, what should be the carrying amount of this machine as on 31st March 2018? They have directly asked you, 18 ka details diya, but they have directly asked you calculate the impairment loss of 2019. So how will you calculate this? Now, इसका calculation will be very easy. So, we'll start with first calculate the carrying value, recoverable value. Recoverable value में क्या क्या आता है आपका? Net selling price and value in use. Now, first calculate how much is the carrying value. 20 crores का, 20 CR का, it was the, we had bought the asset at 20 CR and accumulated depreciation was 16.6. So minus accumulated depreciation was 16.6, and 1 CR is the more depreciation जो आपने 18-19 में किया. We are calculating अपन impairment loss निकाल रहे किसके लिए, या CGU value किसका, या asset का value as on 31st March 2019. Are we clear? So 20 minus 16.6 minus 1. So what is the value of the carrying amount of the plant? The carrying amount comes to 2.4. Correct? Now, estimated net selling prices on last year was 1.2, which is expected to decline by 20%. Matlab, yes, year mein net selling price will be how much? In this year, the net selling price will be 0.96. After that, value in use was 1.4, which is expected to decrease by 30%. So this will come to 0.98. Now, whichever is higher, which one is higher? That is 0.98. So you will compare 0.98 value with carrying value of 2.4. Hence, what will be the impairment loss? Impairment loss will come to 1.42. Impairment loss will be, so how will we present the sum? You start with carrying value of plant before impairment on 31st March 19. It was 2.4 CR. Then carrying value of plant. Carrying value of plant after impairment. Carrying value of plant after impairment. Yeah, basically aap log directly kar sakte ho if you want to do. Since you have already done the working. Recoverable value or value in is whichever is higher, that is 0.98. So directly you can say what is the amount of impairment loss. Amount of impairment loss is nothing but 1.42 CR. Correct? What should be, how much will be the amount of write-off for the financial year 31st March 2019? So how much will the amount of write-off apne abhi nikala hai? See, the first sub-question was what should be the carrying amount? The carrying amount should be this. Second question, what is the value of impairment loss? That is nothing but 1.42 CR. After that, if the machine had been revalued 10 years ago and the current revaluation reserve against the plant were to be 48 lakhs. Agar bola hai ki 48 lakhs mein kab pada hai, then how would you answer, how would your answer to question 1 and 2 in the above value change? Agar revaluation reserve mein already, there was 0.48 lakhs, then how much amount you will charge to P&L? तो इंपेयरमेंट लॉस जो 1.2 सीआर का था, फर्स्ट रिवैल्यूएशन सरप्लस में कितना पड़ा था? देयर वाज ऑलरेडी 0.48 लाख. हेंस द अमाउंट दैट यू विल चार्ज टू पीएनएल फॉर द इंपेयरमेंट लॉस विल बी 1.42 माइनस 0.48. यू विल ओनली चार्ज इट टू 0.94. द अमाउंट दैट यू विल चार्ज टू पीएनएल फॉर द दिस फॉर दिस ईयर फॉर इंपेयरमेंट विल बी ओनली 0.94. आर वी क्लियर? After this, if the value in use was 0 and the company was required to incur a cost of 8 lakh to dispose the plant, what would be your response to question 1 and 2 above? Bolo, how will we do it? If the carrying value to apne ko pata hai 2.4 tha. Now, what are they saying? Realizable, aapka jo bhi recoverable value hai, that is value in net selling price and value in use. What are they saying? If the value in use was 0 and net selling price and you are required to incur a cost of 8 lakh. Aapko 8 lakh ka cost bhi incur karna padega. So basically aapka recoverable value minus 8 pe ja raha hai. In such case, if you remember the start of the lecture, the maximum amount you can charge to the impairment. Aap kitna impairment loss bata sakte ho? That is, you can decrease the entire carrying value. You can decrease the entire carrying value. Matlab, the entire book value of the plant will be written off in this case because recoverable value is zero. Nahi. You have to pay more. So the entire carrying amount will be taken to written off and taken to P&L. And for rupees 8, what are we going to do? 8 ke liye, as per Ind AS 37, will make a provision because there's a present obligation. We will make a provision. So journal entries kya pass karenge? Impairment loss of entire 24 will be taken to PPE 24, and we will, second entry will pass disposal cost of rupees 8 will be disposal cost of 8 to provision of 8. This we already discussed the start of the lecture only, that in case the maximum amount of
इम्पेयरमेंट यू कैन पास दैट यू कैन ब्रिंग द एंटायर अमाउंट टू निल. एक बार निल लाने के बाद इट गोज आउट ऑफ इंड एस 36 एंड देन इट गोज टू इंड एस 37. उसके बाद भी अगर कुछ कॉस्ट है तो आपको प्रोविजन करना पड़ेगा. सो वी आर डन विथ इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 16. बट देयर अ स्मॉल थिंग, देयर अ स्मॉल थिंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर कि वी हैव बीन डायरेक्टली आस्क्ड टू कैलकुलेट इंपेयरमेंट फॉर 2019. अपने पास पूरा डेटा है 2018 का. वॉट इफ, जस्ट इज एन एक्स्ट्रा बट, वॉट इफ कंपनी कैरिड आउट इंपेयरमेंट इन द ईयर 2018. सी डायरेक्टली दे आस्क यू टू कैलकुलेट इंपेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ 2019, आप डायरेक्टली करोगे, 18 पर कभी आप करोगे नहीं. बट वॉट इफ द कंपनी, इफ वी आर सपोज टू कैरी आउट इंपेयरमेंट टेस्टिंग इन द ईयर 2018, तो हाउ विल डू इट. सो नाउ वॉट विल द कैरिंग वैल्यू, वन सेकेंड. सो कैरिंग वैल्यू कितना रहेगा आपका नाउ, 20 - 16.6, करेक्ट. सो दैट इज हाउ मच, दिस इज 3.4. दिस इज फॉर द ईयर 18-19. डेप्रिसिएशन जो दिया, सॉरी, दिस इज फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31st March 18, दैट इज ईयर 17-18. डेप्रिसिएशन इज गेन फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर. अपन 31st March 18 को देख रहे हैं. कंपेयर इट विद द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू. वॉट इज द रिकवरेबल वैल्यू? नेट सेलिंग प्राइस. नेट सेलिंग प्राइस इज हाउ मच, 1.2. एंड वैल्यू न्यूज कितना दिया, 1.4. विच एवर इज हायर, विच वन इज हायर इन आर केस, दैट इज 1.4. सो डायरेक्टली देर इज एन इम्पेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ, इन द ईयर 17-18 ही देर इज एन इम्पेयरमेंट लॉस, देर इज एन इम्पेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ रुपीज 2 crore, करेक्ट. नाउ सो रिवाइज कैरिंग वैल्यू आफ्टर इम्पेयरमेंट कितना हो जाएगा, रिवाइज कैरिंग वैल्यू आफ्टर इंपेयरमेंट विल बी 3.4. से वी हैव गॉट इंपेयरमेंट लॉस 2 का पास किया है. सो द असेट वैल्यू इज नाउ 1.4. नाउ यू विल कम इन द ईयर 2019, जहां पे आप कैरिंग वैल्यू का डेप्रिसिएशन पास करोगे 1. सो हाउ मच विल बी योर कैरिंग अमाउंट? कैरिंग अमाउंट एज ऑन 31st March 2019 विल बी नथिंग बट 0.4. कैरिंग अमाउंट विल बी, कैरिंग अमाउंट विल बी 0.4, करेक्ट. वन सेकेंड सम इश्यू. सो कैरिंग वैल्यू कम्स टू 0.4. So carrying value comes to 0.4. Now you will compare this with recoverable value. Recoverable value कितना दिया आपको? Net selling price and value in use. So recoverable amount is 0. यह अपने already अपने calculate अभी किया है. That is 0.96. Sorry, guys, some problem with the system. If you have just calculated, that is 0.96 and 0.98, whichever is higher, that is 0.98. So actually in year 18-19, if you see, there is no impairment only. But yes, sab mein we have taken it in the other way. We have directly been asked ki 31st March 2019 mein impairment kya hua hai. Maybe 18 mein impairment testing, they might have not done. So impairment loss, if we had passed impairment entries in 18-19, so year in 17-18, so year 18 mein impairment loss would be, in year 18-19 impairment loss would be nil. Are we clear? Great. Chalo, let's move on to the next illustration. That is illustration number 18. Sorry, illustration number 17 is left. Illustration number 17. PQR, illustration number 17 is an RTP question that is in May 2020 RTP mein they have asked. So PQR is a company which has performed well in the past, but one of its major asset, that is an item of equipment, suffered a significant and unexpected deterioration in the performance. Management expects to use the machine for a further 4 years after 31st March 2016, but at a reduced level. The equipment will be scrapped after 4 years. The financial accountant of PQR has produced a set of cash flow projection for the equipment for the next 4 years, ranging from optimistic to pessimistic. CFO thought that the projection was too conservative and he intended to use the highest figure each year. Those were as follow: 31st March 17 was 276, 18 is 192, 19 is 120, and 2020 is 114. The above cash inflow should be assumed to occur on the last day of the each financial year. The pre-tax discount rate is 9%. The machine could have been sold on 31st March 2016 for rupees 6 lakh and related selling expense in this regard could have been 96,000. The carrying value of the asset as on 31st March 16 was 6 lakh 60. The Indian government had indicated that it may compensate the company for any loss in the value of asset up to its recoverable amount. Calculate the impairment loss, if any. Revised depreciation for the asset also suggests how impairment loss, if any, would be set off and how compensation from government will be accounted for. So here, directly we bought the asset 4 years back and today we are in the year 2016. So we have been directly given the carrying amount as on 31st March 2016 is 6 lakh 60. Now we compare this with the recoverable value. Matlab kya? Either you have net selling price and you have value in use. Do cheez hota hai. So let's see, first calculate the value in use. You have been given all the next 4 years ka 17 18 19 and 20. Cash flow is 2 lakh 76,000, 1 lakh 92, 1 lakh 20,000, and 1 lakh 14,000. We have been given all the cash inflows. You have the discounting factor also, which is at the rate 9%. That is coming to 0.9174, 0.8417, 0.7722, and 0.7084. So amount after discounting comes to 2,53,202. You can do the calculation: 161,606, 92,664, and 80,758. So the total value in use comes to 5,88,230, correct? So this value in use will be 588,230. We have the net selling price also. Do we have the net selling price? Yes, we have. That is 6 lakh is the fair value and estimated selling expense is 96,000. So the net selling price comes to 5,04,000. The net selling price comes to 5,04,000. One second. This is 5,04,000. So here now recoverable value is whichever is higher. In this case the higher amount is 5,88,000. So recoverable value aapka aaya 5,88,230. Carrying amount is 6,60,000. So now you can easily calculate the impairment loss. What is the impairment loss? Impairment loss is nothing but carrying amount minus recoverable value 588,230. This comes to impairment loss comes to 71,770. And what is the revised carrying value? Revised carrying value comes to, your carrying amount was 6,60,000 and there is an impairment loss. There is an impairment loss of 71,770. Hence, the revised carrying amount comes to 5,88,230. So now, if you want to calculate a depreciation, what is the depreciation? Depreciation is remaining life of the asset is only 4 years. There is no scrap value. So 5,88,230 minus 0 divided by 4. So per annum depreciation comes to 1,47,058 per annum. So now, what have they given? They have given one more thing. The impairment loss of 71,000, jitna bhi aapko aaya hai, you take it to P&L. But if if there is any revaluation surplus in relation to the same asset, तो पहले आपको उसमें से निकालना पड़ेगा. सम में दे हैव क्लियरली गिवन दैट देर इज एन दैट असेट हैज बीन प्रीवियसली रिवैल्यूड एज ऑन 31 मार्च 16 अमाउंट ऑफ 36,000 वॉज हेल्ड इन रिवैल्यूशन सरप्लस. तो डायरेक्टली एंटायर इंपेयरमेंट लॉस ऑफ 71,750 कैन नॉट बी टेकन टू पी एन एल आउट ऑफ द लॉस ऑफ 71,770 out of the loss of 71,770, 36,000 first will be written off against revaluation surplus and remaining of 35,770 will be charged to PNL. And there one more thing given that if there is any impairment loss, the same will be compensated by the government. So how will you treat the compensation? Treatment of government compensation. Government is ready to give you compensation for any impairment loss. So any compensation by the government would be accounted as and when it becomes receivable. At this time, government has only stated that it may reimburse the company. Therefore, credit should not be taken for any government. Jab aayega tab lena. Abhi we cannot take any credit to the any potential government receipt. We cannot take credit for. Clear? Let's come to illustration number 18. It's a mock test question. Mock test paper question, illustration number 18. X Limited purchased a property, plant and equipment PPE 4 years ago for 150 lakhs and depreciated at 10% per annum on straight line basis method. At the end of 4th year, it had revalued the asset at rupees 75 lakh and had written off the loss on revaluation to the profit and loss account. However, on the date of revaluation, the market price is 67.5 lakhs and expected disposal cost is 3 lakhs. What will be the treatment in respect of impairment loss on the basis that fair value for revaluation purpose is determined by market value and the value in use is estimated at 60 lakhs? Again, a very easy question. Jada kuch hai nahi. First, let's calculate the purchase price. What is the carrying amount? Carrying amount कितना है PPE का? Carrying amount is you bought it at 150 lakhs. आपने 4 years back लाया तो अभी depreciation कितना होगा आज की book आज के day पे? What will be the carrying value at year 4 end? So 150 asset you bought it at 10 साल depreciate होने वाला है. You used it for 4 years. So depreciation will be 60. So carrying value at year 4 will be 90 lakhs. Correct? And then immediately you revalued the asset as 75 lakhs. So aapne directly revalue kar diya usko kitne pe 75 lakhs. That means what you have done is you have done a downward revaluation. You have done a downward revaluation which will be charged to profit and loss account at how much? You have done it at 15. Correct? Now we will calculate is what is the impairment. So as per the impairment thing, you calculate carrying value, compare it with the recoverable value. Recoverable value is nothing but your value, your net selling price and value in use. In this case, the net selling price is given how much? 67.5 diya hai minus there is something selling expense. So 67.5 minus 3 lakhs. Ye kitna hota hai aapka net selling price comes to 64.5. And how much is your value in use? Value in use, they have directly given ki the value in use is 60 lakhs. Correct? They have directly given. So whichever is higher. Which one is higher? 64.5. So in this case, carrying value apna kitna hai? 75. So there is an impairment loss of how much? So you have to calculate impairment loss. An impairment loss of 10.5 lakh. That is 75 minus 64.5, which will be recognized in the profit and loss. Ye pura ka pura PNL mein jayega because pehle downward revaluation tha. Had it been an upward revaluation, we would have taken it to first revaluation surplus and then karte. But idhar case mein there was a downward revaluation. So wapas agar downward revaluation hoga, to pura ka pura amount will go in your PNL account. Are we clear? Great. Now, next illustration, again it's a mock test paper question, that is illustration number 19. Himalaya Limited, which is in the business of manufacturing and export of its product, sometimes back in 2016, the government of India, the government put restriction on export of goods exported by Himalaya. And due to that, because government had restriction, it impaired its asset. Himalaya Limited acquired identifiable asset worth rupees 4,000 lakhs for rupees 600 lakhs at the end of year 2011. 400 ke asset, jo jitne asset ka worth 4,000 tha, Himalaya acquired it for 6,000. Matlab, it paid 2,000 lakhs for goodwill. The difference is treated as goodwill. The useful life of the asset is 15 years and depreciated on straight line basis. When government put the restriction at the end of 2016, the company recognized the impairment loss by determining the recoverable amount of asset of rupees 2720 lakhs. In 2018, government lifted the restriction imposed on the export, and due to favorable change, Himalaya Limited re-estimated the recoverable amount, which was estimated at 3420, required calculate and allocate of impairment loss in 2016. So, okay, first let's see what is the historical cost that it borrowed. It purchased the asset. So it purchased identifiable asset. It purchased identifiable asset at 4,000 lakhs, and with that it also paid 2,000 ka goodwill. So total carrying value of the entire asset is 6,000. Correct. Now 4 years he purchased the asset in some back in 2012, and now in 2016, so depreciation for 4 years aega. That is, asset is used for how many years? That is, if I'm not wrong, asset is used for 15 years. That is 4,000 divided by 15. That is into 4. That is 1067. The depreciation amount is 1067. Goodwill never depreciates and never amortizes. We always check for annual impairment. So what is the carrying amount? What is the carrying amount before impairment? Before impairment, what is the carrying amount? Is 2000, and this is nothing but 2933. The total carrying value becomes to 4933. Now the government imposed a restriction, and the asset and the recoverable value of the asset is only 2720. So carrying amount, what is the recoverable value? Recoverable value is only 2720. That means we'll have to pass impairment loss of how much? There's an impairment loss of 2213. Now, first, allocate the entire loss to the goodwill, and remaining will go on to the other asset. Remaining loss will go on to other asset of 213. Correct? So, now what is the carrying amount after loss? Carrying amount after impairment loss kitna ho gaya aapka? This will be 0. This will come to 2720. Correct? You have deducted 2123, and carrying amount is, totality is 2720. Now 2 years have passed. Government again took off the ban. You can start exporting now. So end of 2018. End of 2018. What is the carrying amount? 2720. Now again there will be depreciation and everything. So again there will be depreciation. Carrying amount kitna hai? Goodwill there is nothing. Identifiable asset is 2720. Now 2 years have passed. That is 2 years depreciation. So he bought the asset for 15 years. There are 4 years have already passed. So abhi bacha kitna? Aur 11 years bacha hai. Now 11 years is still left. And 2 years ke baad, what will be the amount of the asset? That is carrying amount kitna hoga? It will be 2225. Now the recoverable value, the moment company reimposed the ban, the asset service potential got increased. Asset began. So impairment, reversal of impairment kab hoga? When there is an increase in service potential. The moment lift got banned, there was improvement in the service potential, and recoverable value of the asset is 3420. So what is the excess? What is the excess? That is excess of recoverable value over carrying kitna hai? 1195. So now can we deduct or can we reverse the entire impairment loss or no? We'll have to discuss. So we will calculate first thing, calculate carrying value, ignoring impairment. So what is the historical cost of the asset? Asset was for 4,000 and depreciation, now 6 years have passed. That is, depreciation kitna tha? 4,000 divided by minus depreciation. 4,000 divided by 15 into 6 years have passed. That is 1,600. So what is your depreciated historical cost? 2,400. Max to max matlab how much? So if you want to reverse the impairment, you can reverse up to how much? Recoverable value or carrying value of the asset, whichever is lower. So max to max you can bring the asset from 225 to 2,400. Hence, what will we do? What will journal entry will pass or show the working? Chalo. Carrying amount of asset at end of 2018 is how much? Goodwill is zero. Identifiable asset is 2225. You will add reversal of impairment. Kitna aapko reversal aapne kiya? You are only allowed to reverse only 175. Hence carrying value after the reversal comes to 2400. Are we clear? And now we come on to the last illustration, that is illustration number 20. Great Limited, again this is a mock test paper question. Great Limited acquired a machine on 1st April 2012 for ₹7 crore. There is an estimated useful life of 7 years. The machine is on depreciated on straight line basis and does not carry any residual value. On 1st April 2016, the carrying value of the machine was reassessed at 5.1 CR. And the surplus which is arising on the revaluation is credited to revaluation reserve. That is correct. For the year ended 31st March, conditions indicating an impairment of the machine existed and the amount recoverable was certain to be only rupees 79 lakhs. Calculate the loss of impairment on the machine and show how this loss is to be treated in the books of Great Limited. Great Limited had a business policy of writing down the revaluation surplus by increased charge of depreciation resulting from revaluation. Matlab, because aapne revaluation kiya, uske wajah se jo bhi extra depreciation tha, that will also be taken from revaluation surplus. That's the policy the company is following. Okay, that's not an issue, we'll follow. So first calculate the carrying amount. Carrying amount of machine on 1st April 2012, that is how much in crores? That is 7 CR, correct? Now we will depreciate it for 4 years. We bought it in 1st April 2012. Now we are on 1st April 2016. So 4 years are done. So we will depreciate it abhi 7 divided by 7 into 4 years. That is 4 crores the depreciation. So what is the carrying amount? So carrying amount as on 31st March 2016 is nothing but only 3 CR, correct? Now, what have they done is they have reassessed the asset value at 5.10 crore. Matlab upward revaluation hua hai. So you add upward revaluation of how much? 2.10. So what is the carrying amount? The carrying amount of machine on 1st April 2016 that is revalued comes to 5.10. Now 2 years have passed, again 2 years have passed, and now we are in March 2018 where there are indicators of impairment. So again you will less depreciation for 2 years. How much is the depreciation? So how many years have passed earlier? 4 years have already passed. Now you have more 6 years. So total depreciation. One second. So depreciation for 2 years. 4 years have already passed. Now you have only 3 years. That is 5.10 divided by 3. And for 2 years, it will be 3.4 per annum. So what is your carrying value now? The carrying amount on 31st March 2018 is nothing but 1.70. Now there are indicators of impairment, and you compare it with the recoverable value, which is given is of only 0.79. So how much is the impairment loss you will record? How much is the impairment loss you will record is 0.91. Now they are asking ki 0.91 ko aap books mein kaise bataunge. Now you already had a revaluation surplus of 2.10. Jab aapne upward revaluation kiya tha, aapke paas 2.10 ka tha. But company had a policy that the excess depreciation because of revaluation will also be taken from revaluation. So excess depreciation kitna tha pehle? Without revaluation aap depreciation karte the 1 ka. Abhi with revaluation that is 1.7. So excess that is 0.7 for 2 years that is 1.4 is taken from revaluation. So abhi revaluation mein kitna paisa bacha? 2.10 minus 1.4. You have balance of only 0.7. Hence 0.7 will be first set off against. Hence 0.7 first will be set off against revaluation surplus. And the balance. Balance kitna bacha? You were supposed you had impairment loss of 0.91, but 0.7 is taken off. You have 0.7 you have set off against the revaluation reserve balance. Hence balance of impairment loss to be taken to P&L will be 0.21. Here the only thing that in the sum, a simple company follows a different accounting policy. Jo jitna bhi revaluation se extra depreciation hua hai, that will be also taken care by revaluation. That's why whatever revaluation reserve we had 2.10, usme se jitna bhi apne excess depreciation kiya tha, pehle depreciation 1 crore per annum hota tha, abhi 1.7 ho gaya. So excess of 0.7 ye 2 saal ke liye chala. To 1.4 apne revaluation mein se nikala for depreciation. To abhi revaluation mein kitna bacha? 0.7. Impairment loss aapko aaya tha 0.91 ka. So 0.7 is set off against the revaluation balance and rest impairment loss is debited to P&L of 0.21. Are we clear guys? So this ends our impairment.